What's up, YouTube? It's your boy, GMB. I'm back with another video. And I ran into this screenshot, meaning this picture, about the cost of success. And by the way, the 5G towers, they're all real. And they're already here. I already found one today. Look at that. That's a 5G tower. So 5G towers are here, and they already been supplemented, planted all over the damn cities and states and everything. It's already up. They just need time to program, but it's a bad thing. So I was looking at this cost of success picture, and I'm looking at it like, okay, yeah. Let me explain this out to you real quick. This is a screen recording, not a video. This is a screen recording of me talking to y'all. I'm not trying to make the video too long. I'm not trying to make it do that. I'm here to talk about the cost of success and this 5G tower shit. But all right, the cost of success, bam, right here. The cost of success: late nights, true, early mornings, very few friends, being misunderstood, feeling overwhelmed, questioning your sanity. Yes, number one, late nights. Yes, I've been up late at night thinking about video ideas, editing. I have crazy dreams. My intuition is getting stronger. Look at that moon. Hold on, where is that? Look at that moon. And it's talking about when the sun go down, moon come up. The moon already up and the sun up. Oh, you see the sun around my face. They lied to us, man. But yeah, I be up late at night. Ain't gonna lie. Just thinking about video ideas. What can I do? What's funny? I'm about to do a video, another video. I'm about to do another prank call, a little parody. That's kind of funny. So and I'm doing a little bit of single videos. That gonna come on the way. And I'll be doing some other shit. Early mornings. I mean, I was doing the one of my dancing videos at 6 o'clock in the morning. Real shit. And like, I keep myself up during the day because I don't want to be late. Don't want to be up late as night. But at the same time, I still be up late as night. That's crazy, ain't it? Okay, the third one was very few friends. I do have very few friends. I really don't talk to nobody no more. I don't talk to nobody. I can show you right now. All this is three girls right there. Shout outs. My homeboy was just replying to my snap. She texted me out of the blue. I really don't text. I leave these people on red, bro. Or they leave me on red. It's real shit, bro. I don't really don't talk to nobody. I only got like three or four friends, for real, for real. My circle is very small, and I'm glad it's small. But the thing about it is, I need to reach out to people that I can do some videos with. But that's gonna be later after this quarantine over, all these rules and regulations about this quarantine. What the next one was? Being misunderstood, yes. When I tell people I want to be a comedian, they thinking, oh, you mean get on the stage and talk jokes. No, I'm talking about YouTube comedian. Post videos, and I also want to do singing videos, and I want to do dancing videos, singing and dancing videos, and I want to do NBA highlights. And it, like, people love to judge a nigga for no reason. I understand that. I don't give a fuck though. So yeah, people understood and misunderstood me. They don't know my goals and aspirations. They don't know all that. But guess what? When I start seeing results, they gonna be shut the fuck up. Oh, making my haters my clients. I see a vision. I have a vision. Nobody don't see it but me. My thing is technology, not reconstruction, not slicing some wood, measuring wood, doing all that extra shit. No, I don't do that. I know that ain't my purpose. All right, now I'm getting these headphones off. Just like, what you doing? Yeah. So, and the next one is Mr. Understanding, something like that. Feeling overwhelmed. Yes. Overwhelmed, oh yes, because this kind of thing is stressful. I be wanting this shit to be blow up very fast because this type of shit I do, I find it very funny. I find it very funny. And then when I posted on Snapchat, some people replied to me with laughing emojis. And so I was like, okay, that's two or three people. But why is not nobody, like, if I post something about some girls, my crushes, it blows up. All the girls are talking about it. Telling on it, telling different screenshot and everything. Oh, this boy like you. He wanted you so bad on his video. He posted. And everybody trying to text me. Why you posted? Why you posted? You weird as fuck. All that shit. All that. But don't want to admire. Don't want to admire me when I'm doing my like my little funny videos. No one want to screenshot that. No one want to repost that. No one want to screen record that. Repost it. Hey, go subscribe to him. Subscribe to him. No, none of that. And I put my Instagram on. On Snapchat, so don't even do that. I put that for a whole 24 hours. Nobody follow my ass. I still got 9 followers right now. So I don't want to hear that. But like I said, when I see results, people gonna be asking for shout outs. I ain't gonna do shout outs until I get very big. Like I got 1K in my main channel, and then my personal channel is GMB Time. That get like 5K. That's only way I do a little shout out. You gotta pay me like $10. $10 for a shout out. But other than that, why hit 5K? 5K? Alright, let's explode. Let's get to 10,000, 40,000, 80,000. Let's get to 100, and then 1 mil, 2 mil. Then we're gonna have to explode like that. But thinking about it right now, When all those people started watching my video, I felt the pressure of it. I felt overwhelmed. I was like, oh shit, is this video good enough? Or is this funny? And I started second think myself. And now I'm not as faithful to it. I'm not as confident in it. That's what I mean. I feel overwhelmed. Because when certain type of people watch my video that I know, the key word that I know, then it becomes a problem, cause they don't tell me the truth, and then I'm second guessing the video. So maybe I should just delete it. Maybe I should not post on here. Now they getting inside my head. Now I don't need it. The thought of me being this YouTube comedian, this big YouTuber, is going out the window because of what somebody else said or what somebody thinks about me. But I really gotta learn not to give a fuck. I just learned yesterday. Patience is key. So I'm gonna have to wait, but I still got to work at it every day. That's what I'm doing. I'm doing a video today. I'm posting another video tomorrow. Just keep it going. That's what I mean by being overwhelmed. Next one is question your sanity. Like people, when I posted this video, I think I posted it right here. Play the clip, girl. Ooh, she
she do a thing, thing, lames. Get shot down, she do a bang, bang. She attract rappers and the ones who do the same thing. Players in the league and the dope boy who slang things. All tryna pull up on her, all she do is lane change. They be in the air, wanting her to be the main thing. Tryna lock her down, she ain't with the chain gang. Wanna make a wifey, but no name change. She be on that Birkin to Chanel type of name change.
Yeah, when I posted that video, whole life female started, "Oh my God, you don't know why you post that." Then, like, my 12th grade crush texts me. I'm gonna have to do a story time on that one. She texted me out of the blue, telling me this and that. That's cool and all, Gabriel, but why is some people be thinking that you creepy and stuff? I didn't really give a fuck. I didn't give a fuck. Why are you giving a fuck? And then she gonna repost it. But she never reposted my, one of my shit, though. That's funny, and that's crazy. That's crazy. That's real crazy. But like I said, people question myself. Why you would do that? Why you do? Are you stupid? Are you you creepy? You all that question my sanity. Like, this nigga is stupid. This nigga dumb. Why you doing that? Just get a job. Why you doing that? Shut the fuck up. That's for me, bro. That's for me and my plans, bro. And I feel like I'm trying to find my damn passion. I'm bouncing around it. I feel like I'm bouncing around it. I'm in the vicinity, but I'm not particularly touching on it. I'm not touching on it yet. But I don't know what it is. I really don't know what it is. But I'm going to keep doing my shit. I'm going to keep doing my shit. Whatever I'm doing right now, the funny videos, parodies, everything. I'm going to keep doing my shit until I reached a certain limit, and that's be like 100 videos or 200 videos or 500 videos. I already got 500 videos on my GMB all time channel. You see that? I'm proud of that. And I'm gonna blow up. I will blow up. But don't blow, I will die trying. That's real facts. That's facts, my nigga. Oh, so yeah, question your sanity. The one was last one was being your own chiller. I got a video on that. It's called Our GME, bitch. Play the club, Gary.
I am what? I am GMB. You cannot stop that. This is my ego right here. I'm born to shine. And I'm putting it out there. It's going to happen. Everything gonna be all right, Jim. But you don't have to worry about nothing. You don't have to worry about a damn thing. You said, "Oh, nigga got an Android." I don't give a fuck. The thing about it, I don't give a fuck. Fuck your iPhone. Fuck whatever you got in your hand, and fuck with me, cause I am what, GMB, bitch. Yeah, I know.
I'm gonna do a whole lot of editing, but yeah, it was crazy, man. It's crazy. I'm just so proud of myself that I started this channel. Now, 2 years from now, 2 or 3 years from now, I can look back at myself like, okay, he started that, and I can look back at him. But like, from right now, today's May 2nd, tomorrow May 3rd, I do a story time on the date May 3rd, whatever. I do a story time on what happened 2 years ago that I wish I would have recorded. So now I'm recording everything, every particular thing in my life. I will record it because I'm always gonna remember it. I don't give a damn if you don't get no views anyway. I want to record it. I want to make it into a video. So whenever I go out somewhere, next time I go out, I'm gonna record. I'm gonna fuck what you say. It's for my YouTube channel. Go subscribe. Yeah. So yeah, I gotta be my own chiller. Yeah, I gotta chill myself on. I'm be optimistic. I'm a Sagittarius, so I'm very optimistic. Sometimes I'm not. Sometimes, mostly I am. I like to have fun. I like to be me. I don't like to be nobody. I like to be me, bro. I really like to say what I want to. Sometimes I really like to laugh. I love to laugh. Now I love to laugh, though. I really love to laugh because I'm having a great time joking around and shit. That's really make me happy. And they make my vibration very high. You know, my vibration is very high. No one can stop me. When I'm singing, dancing, laughing, joking, singing, all that shit, playing basketball, I'm living my life. And I'm free at the same time. I'm not living my best life yet. But I will when I get my apartment. When I get my apartment, that's when I will live my best life, because I'm free, and nobody can tell me nothing to do, because I'm wet. GMB. So that's what you mean being on chiller. You gotta cheer yourself on, have hope in yourself. That's the cost of success. And I had to learn it. I'm learning it right now. But GMB, I'll see y'all next video.